Hello everyone, and welcome back to DMG. To magnetic media. There's one main difference. Well, actually two. Of course, this is a long tape on a spool. And this is just a disc of tape. It's basically hard drive platter in a little box. That's basically what a floppy is. That's how it works. Of course, with a long tape, you can store a lot more data, but you don't get fast random access or any random access at all like you get with one of these. However, the much smaller size one of these can hold makes them a lot worse at storing audio, like these are very good at. So, that's what we're gonna do today. As far as I know, there is no way to store audio in a conventional way on a floppy disk. So that means you can't store analog audio on these. I'm gonna try in a future video, maybe, to put analog audio on a floppy. But, you know, today I'm going to try and compress some MP3s so low that they fit on a floppy. Okay. So here we go. Floppy disk drive. Yeah, it's a floppy disk. I'll go in here, go to music. This is what I use for my YouTube videos. Now we can see most of these are in the multiple megabytes. This FLAC file is actually 43 megs. Most of them are in the double digits megabytes. That one is not, though. A couple of these ATI ones, because they're compressed really low, aren't very big, but that's, again, because the audio quality is pretty awful. You know, if you get into OGG files that are less compressed, if you get into the OGG files included with Unreal Tournament 2004, a lot of these will actually already fit on a floppy because they aren't very big files. Let's see. However, this one's 1.5 megabytes, just over the line. But what if we take, like, an actual song? Now, this is not the smallest of files. This is a 5-minute, 10-second song. 256 kilobyte bitrate. Pretty standard. That's CD bitrate, as far as I know, because this is CD quality audio. And, yeah, it's a decently sized little file. It's almost 10 megabytes. So, can we make it smaller? We'll try. Now, probably one of the easiest things to do is, well, other than just, if you just took part of the song and lopped it off, of course you lose part of the song there, so you wouldn't want to do that. Now, what you can obviously do is change the bitrate. I think I'm just gonna settle for, yeah, that's exactly half the quality. Now I'm going to export it as an MP3. I'll try that first. 145 to 185 kilobytes per second. So yes, that is a slightly lower quality. All right, so that turned the size into almost exactly a third. It's now 3.5 megabytes. All right. It sounds a bit more muffled on the vocals, but overall we haven't lost too much quality yet. So I wonder how much actually turning it into mono would help. Let's try that. Okay, so we've got half the size now. It's down to about 2 megs. With this song, though, it uses the two channels in a very good way. It's one of those songs that you really need both channels to appreciate. So even though the waveform looks almost exactly the same, when they're just squeezed into one package, it doesn't sound too good. Now I could try other alternatives, like maybe we turn down the bitrate another step. Export to MP3. Now this, at this point, your bitrate is getting just really awful. Okay, now that's 1.47 megs. and it's gonna start sounding like crap. Okay, it's at this point that it kind of sounds, it's at this point where it kind of starts to sound like you're listening to the song through the wall of your neighbor who's playing it very loudly on a poorly amplified phone speaker. So, sorry, that's oddly specific. You can probably tell that I live in a dorm with people who do that. I'm gonna turn down the bitrate even further and see just how far I can push MP3, and then I'll try a different format. Once you get down to 8 kilohertz, it's just not worth it. Versus the original, which in the same part should sound like. Alright, so our badly mutated MP3, out of all of these, there is only one that we can actually fit on the disc. Okay, so this is what you get with an OGG. You get just a quality slider. If we turn it all the way up to 10, let's see how big that is. It's going to be huge, probably. Yeah, 3.25 megabytes, can't fit that on a floppy. But that is still a third of what we got with the MP3, the original. I'll just turn it down to 5 and see what I can do here. Okay, that got it down to 2 megs. Maybe like 2 or 3 would do. I think that sounds worse than the worst MP3 that I compressed it down to. I gotta listen to them side by side. Give me a sec. All right, so we've got a bit of an interesting trade-off here. With the OGG file, it sounds like you're listening to it on good speakers, but through a pillow. However, with the MP3, you get fewer channels. You're down to mono, which I believe I exported the OGG in stereo. Yeah, I did. So you get one fewer channel, or I guess you get the channels squished together into a Frankenstein's monster of audio bits. It's unsettling. It is deeply dissatisfying. So actually, I think, get out of here, MP3. I'm going to be using the OGG file. Here we go. Is the floppy fast enough to smoothly play back this bitrate audio file? Time to find out. It worked. It worked. It actually worked. All right. So, obviously, it did work. I just tried to right-click and eject a floppy. I am so dumb. All right. Might as well try this in my Windows 98 laptop. Time to see what that Sound Blaster compatible can do. I'm just going to film it like this. Best I can do. Alright, so it works, but you could hear that we had a bunch of dropouts. Yes, I usually talk like this with my hands, you just don't usually see it in videos. Anyway, that also happened with playing back audio files from a zip drive on this laptop. So I'm not sure if it's the 360 megahertz K6 just not having a good day, or if it's that, you know, maybe the drive is a bit slow, or because you heard it played back flawlessly on this computer. So, you know, maybe just the way it reads the disc is a slight bit different. Now, again, I just want to say there is absolutely no practical usage for putting music on a floppy. If you really want to listen to music on a magnetic format, get one of these. Depending on which tape you get, they sound really good, actually. Some of them almost sound exactly like CDs. But I think that's all I can do with this floppy for today. Thank you everyone for watching, and see you next time.